This is where we're staying, and this is nighttime. That's the bayou. And we hear there's alligators in here, so I'm not gonna stay out. We're late. There's a new moon.
Everything it needed to create sugar from Haiti. And then in the late 1700s, Haiti had a slave rebellion, and they didn't allow us to bring in products from Haiti anymore. So we didn't have to make them on our own. So that's why there's a Louisiana style as well. They do the same thing, they're just stylistically a little different. The way you can really tell the difference is, look for handles. If there's handles coming out of it, that was made in Haiti. If there's no handles, that was made in Louisiana. What's that?
Came to this part of the road, but it looks like it's got water on it, so we're going back all the way to Nevada, backwards. This is Montgomery, Alabama.
Because of the fact the Creoles were here early, they built their houses high, because the natives built their houses high, and they knew that the flood water wasn't going to be a problem. By the time the American family came to Louisiana, one of the things they recognized is that flood water does come through here.
Okay, this is Hotel Lafayette and New Orleans, and it's really fancy. Look at this, and this is me taking a picture, and all beautiful antique furniture and stuff, and we've got a suite. We feel so posh. This is really, really nice. I think I'd like to live here. And there's that. Room, and then there's this dividing place, and we've got a king size bed. That's really soft.
Yeah.
Nice. Oh, I'll try that link in.
You're not getting one.
View out the window.
And the view out the window, okay. The view out the window.
evaluating all of her children. She wanted them all educated equally, just in case one of them, only one of them could run the company. At this point, Elizabeth, though, must have been showing something special. At the age of 13, Elizabeth here was named the assistant manager of the plantation. Wow. Her mother wanted to give her a good inside look at this company, I guess. There's a flaw in that business plan, though. She's 13. She knew about them down. So it wasn't so much she trying to tell a story as much as she really wanted these memories preserved. And she began with her great-grandfather. But she writes about this man. Her great-grandfather's name is Guillaume Duparc. Guillaume was originally living in Normandy. She knew that, so he was in northern France. But he ends up in the United States because of the American Revolution. And in honesty, that's about...
solid high-speed driving without seeing land. It's the longest bridge we've ever been on, maybe in the world, but we don't know. Maybe China has a longer one these days. But we've just been to a crab festival, which was kind of fun. Very, very, very hot. We ate some, Trill ate a whole crab without picking at it. He just ate it straight down. And I had a hot dog, taking the safer option. And we had a nice chat to a couple who lost lots of things in Katrina. And there is actually a storm brewing right now as we speak. So there's a little concern, and we don't know whether it's heading to Florida or it may head straight to New Orleans, which is where we're going to be. Or New Orleans. Cyclone Debbie.
Hurricane
Debbie. So that's it for now. So if nothing gets added to this, then it's possible that we got swept away in the Debbie hurricane. So goodbye to all the family and all our loved ones, and we love you all, and we're thinking of you as we
go around this corner that we have no idea where we are
down the lake. Yeah.